As always, this broadcast will be rated F for fake. Guys, please bear with me with this long introduction, but I need to do this in order to demonstrate how long this campaign against humanity has been going on. And this is just a small taste for a reminder of you of this campaign to push this disinformation against the American people has been going on for a very long time. And I'm going to introduce my video now with a song from the 80s. And I will jump right in and we will get into some serious business that will be pretty darn interesting, I believe. Let's check it out.
Yo, know, they trying to come down on the ATL when we speak. They say we on the negative tip. What's up?
Now I'ma kick away our style that's smooth and unusual. It's from above the law, so see it's crucial. High beats are kicking and ripping yo with a funky touch. It's done a boot that's right, so see it's too much. D-O-P-E, please don't misdefine it. That's the way that I live and that's the style of my rhyme. That's on time, just like your watch keeps sticking KMG on my side so that my knowledge keeps sticking. Now what's really known as a radio cut when you can't say shit and you can't say
fuck?
I really think you wanna hear it, but the radio station see they still gonna fear it. Yo, I thought this country was based upon freedom of speech, freedom of press, freedom of your own religion. So make your own decision, that's baloney. Cause if I gotta play by your rules, I'm being phony. Yo, I got the cater to this person and that person. I got the rhyme for the white or the black person. Why can't it all be equal? Music is a universal language for all people. I better get off the rambling tip before somebody out the Zim starting to slip. I ain't tripping, I'm steadily flowing and throwing, giving you a dope stop, keeping me on top of the pile. Cause ATL will soon take over the nation. And if you don't wanna hear us, we'll change the station. But we'll sneak in your mind, sink in your mind, creep up behind so fast that you won't have time to deny a brother that's from the streets, trying to teach, hoping to reach. Yo, 187, not one that's known to preach, but I wish for each to have freedom of speech.
Congress shall make no law respecting an establishment of religion, or prohibiting the free exercise thereof, or abridging the freedom of speech, or of the press.
So as we can see, y'all, they've been trying to control the narrative for a very long time, and this thing started as back as early in the 80s. And they've been trying to control the narrative with a plan that the United Nations has for the world called Agenda 21. This is where you hear about the Illuminati and the New World Order and depopulation. And unfortunately, this stuff is no longer conspiracy theory. You know, wear your tinfoil hat to protect your brain from the aliens. This is real documented stuff that's going on. And we have an article here from Mr. Obama, that he comes out, since he's now near the end of his presidency, which we will see if he actually leaves. I think he will, but I do think that's not going to be the end of the story here. And what he has to say is pretty interesting, and you definitely want to, you want to hear this, but I have to make some disclaimers and jump into a couple of other topics definitely related to this before we jump into this and everybody starts saying that I'm just another dumb white racist. Now, one of the stories going on around the internet right now, you can check out InfoWars or NWA or any of these people are doing a story about this, but MTV just did this show, and they have what was called the White Guy Resolution 2017, and this article is talking about how this may very well earn Trump a second term. I haven't dove into this story too much just yet, and I'm probably not going to. There's enough people covering it right now, although I don't see a ton of people covering what I'm about to cover right now, which is kind of disturbing. But basically what they're telling you in this article is they got all these transgender and different colored people and so on and so forth, basically telling you why the white race needs to be exterminated. Now, I guess a big part of this thing that's going on with this alt-right movement, which I've already previously stated that I do not wish to be associated with. So I guess there's a big belief that there is a push in the narrative, mainly by the mainstream media, the government, Hollywood, and so on and so forth, push the narrative that white people need to be bred out of existence. And obviously, if you're a white person, this can be a little troubling. Now, I want to say that I've talked to quite a few of my friends who are not white. I am very open about talking about issues. I feel the only way to really get past all this BS narrative of the tension between other races is to talk to each other openly and frankly and keep open the discussion about stuff that's going on. And I've talked to them about this issue that I've heard about a lot of people in these videos that I'm watching lately all seem to think that there is this push to demonize white people, particularly white males. And I have to say it's interesting because pretty much all the people that I've talked to about this issue all tell me that they're scared for me because I'm white. And I have to say, that's pretty darn interesting. Now, I could say in all fairness that, hey, this is something that the black community's been going through for, what, a couple hundred years? So, you know, it's not like it's something that's new. It just happens to be going in a different direction at the moment. So, I just found that pretty interesting. But once again, I believe this is all mainly narrative pushed by the government, pushed by the media, and pushed by Hollywood. But I do not believe that it actually exists the way that they want it to. I believe this is just trying to cause a problem with something when there isn't something. I watched a brief little bit of a Stefan Molyneux video a little while ago, and he was talking about how, how liberals, even though they're losing right now, they can just get people into college and they can, teach them stuff like about how grasshoppers are getting violated by crickets and bring up an issue where there isn't really one and get everybody to believe it. And I kind of think this is the same type of deal that's going on right now with this stuff about white people, this stuff about transgender, bringing up this stuff that's really not a big deal, but making it a big deal to try to brainwash the public into giving up more rights, freedom, sovereignty, so they can push their agenda. Now, in case you guys haven't seen it, you need to see it. There's this video called With Open Gates, and it's a very brazen, unapologetic documentary. It's about 15, 20 minutes or something, I think, about the realities of immigration. And it has a whole slew of real footage of immigration in other countries. And one of the things they talk about is what the Daily Mail quotes from the video right here, and how an imam is telling the Muslim migrants to breed children with the Europeans to conquer their country and vows we will trample them underfoot. And he straight up says, by raping women, taking multiple wives, and so on and so forth, he's saying how the birth rates are down in all these countries and how they're going to breed white people out of existence. Right, so that's what this immigration thing worldwide is all about. It's about breeding white people out of existence and then bringing the entire planet under Sharia law. And then eventually just get them to give up more and more freedoms until the UN can come in. As UN member Christiana Figueres has said repeatedly, depopulate 80 to 90% of the planet right now to fight global warming. It's all quite laughable, guys, but this is very real. And what the president has to say is all directly related to this. And what he had to say over here in this article on Yahoo, and I don't like using these fake news sites as sources for my stories, but sometimes I just have to. And unfortunately, one of the biggest offenders of fake news and propaganda in the media is Yahoo. But what you'll find quite interesting is the source that they cite in this article is actually a bigger violator of the truth than Yahoo is. So let's just jump right in and let's see what Obama has just admitted about his presidency. And as you can see right here in the title of the story, he straight up says, this is going to be a browner country. Okay. Regardless of what President-elect Donald Trump plans are for immigration, President Barack Obama says there will be inevitable changes to the demographic of the United States. If you stopped all immigration today, which he's not going to, just by virtue of birth rates, this is going to be a browner country. And that's quite interesting that he used the term birth rates. Because isn't it interesting that one of the things that we've been hearing a lot about, especially in this past year or so, is about the decline of birth rates, right? And what he's saying here, because he's talking about browner country birth rates and immigration, right? So what he's telling you right here, to who he told the NPR, Steve Inskeep, who is NPR, obviously, is much, 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 much worse propaganda than pretty much anybody out there. If you've ever actually stopped and listened to this program, it's the one thing that you can listen to and actually know that it's straight up brainwashing propaganda. I can't even listen to it because it just freaks me out. Like, that stuff is really creepy sounding. So he's telling you that even if you stop immigration right now, that this country is already going to be browner with Muslim blood just by changing the population and the breeding statistics in America by breeding out white people and making everybody brown, Muslim. He's telling you. He goes, because of what I've already done in the past 8 years, this is going to change the country forever. And he goes, and if we're not thinking right now about how we make sure the next generation is getting a good education and are instilled with the common creed and the values that make America so special and are cared for and nurtured and loved the way every American child is treated, then we're not going to be as successful. And I find it very interesting a couple of things that he said here, because A, he talked about the next generation, which means they are already making plans to change this generation and to change their thoughts and their behavior and their actions and the laws and so on and so forth. And they're going to get everybody to go along with this plan willingly. And so they need to prepare now for the next generation, because they've already decided that the United Nations and their plan for the world with the globalists, that this is already going to happen. And so they're taking steps now to make sure that they have everything in place when this whole thing starts taking off. And I think it's funny that he uses the word special, cared for, nurtured, loved, right? Because isn't that what all these special snowflakes that they're getting brainwashed by these George Soros and government and media and Hollywood initiatives is having everybody be involved in feelings and make sure everybody's included and cared for and nurtured and loved through inclusion and multiculturalism, which is basically Marxism. And if you don't know what Marxism is, you need to look it up. So he's admitting all this, and he's and of course, the another key buzzword in this is Common Creed, which is Common Core, which is a straight-up spin-off from UNESCO, the United Nations Plan for Education for the World, which has been instilled in the United States, where they are now brainwashing your children to go along with whatever they say is, because they can shape the way your child thinks through education, because no one is going to take them out of the school because they're just too lazy and they don't want to put in the effort. And as I've stated repeatedly, yes, education is free, even though you pay property taxes or whatever to provide to the school. Once again, anything you get from the government is never free. it always comes with a catch, and the catch here is the re-education of your children. And he's coming out and admitted exactly what he's been doing for the past 8 years. He said, it's natural for the whole nation to have some growing pains because of the substantial changes to the world during his 8 years in office. So he came out and told you before the election in 2008 that he was going to fundamentally change America. And what he's telling you now is, I've already fundamentally changed America. And even if I stop getting rid of immigration right now, which I haven't, I've already changed the bloodline of this country forever, and it's going to be a more Muslim country no matter what you do, because I've already got them here. Right? And if you don't think that breeding people out of existence is a real thing, you should go look and see how the Moors conquered Sicily. You might find it very interesting indeed. He said, I started my presidency inheriting a massive crisis of proportions that we haven't seen since the 1930s. It laid bare some long-term and troubling trends about globalization and technology and raising inequality and the fragility of our financial systems and the way each middle-class folks felt they were being squeezed, and the fact that ladders of opportunity seem to be farther and fewer between for people who are trying to get out of poverty. And throughout that process, we also then started seeing, because the economy's not doing so well, some other tensions get laid bare, changing attitudes about sexual orientation and about race and about the nature of families. And once again, he's telling you that they are, see, and this is one thing that people need to understand, because, and I've talked about this before, and for those of you who haven't heard, it's important to realize it's almost impossible for every nation on the planet to be going bankrupt at the same time. I mean, logically and realistically, that doesn't make a whole lot of sense unless it's engineered, and it is. And if you actually go and look up statistics about the declining birth rate, it is actually declining. But they don't want you to know that. But the reason that it's declining, the biggest factor in this, is finances. Because every country in the world, it seems, is struggling financially. A lot of people aren't even wanting to have children until after they're 30. Because they just simply can't afford them. And so they can use this financial crisis not only to get people to change their breeding habits because they just can't afford to have children, but then it can also get them pissed off, and then they can very easily nudge them in directions and get them upset about sexual orientation and about race and about the nature of families. How many times have we seen laws start to get instituted across this country where they want to tell you that your children aren't yours and they belong to the community and they belong to the state, right? And they're using this financial crisis to aggravate all this stuff, to get people to change their behavior, change their thinking, change their ideology. That way they're willing and they want for the government to do exactly what they're doing, because they just don't seem intelligent enough to see the bigger picture, because people are too lazy to do their own research and realize that they're doing all this to bring the world under Sharia law and then depopulate the planet. People are just lazy. Either they don't know the truth, or they don't want to know the truth, or it's just too terrifying, and they just want to live their lives, right? Something like that. But this is what he's telling you, that he's doing all of this stuff, and this is the way they're doing it. And immigration and engineered financial crisis worldwide is exactly how they're doing it. And once they use the financial crisis to get people pissed off, then they can start poking them about all these other issues and make things that don't matter, like grasshoppers violating crickets, and get people all riled up about it and say, we got to put a stop to this, even though it's not even something that's really happening whatsoever. And he said, and throughout that process, we also then started seeing, because when the economy's not doing well, some other tensions get laid bare. And he said, and so it's a big dose. And it's been a lot of stuff that's been coming people really quickly, and it's made folks anxious. Right? So he's saying, yes, I've done all this, and I know it's all coming at you really fast, and I know that you're all really nervous about it, but just relax, it's all cool, this is all going to plan, and before you know it, you'll be in the FEMA camps getting depopulated, and it won't matter anymore, so just relax. It's all good, it's all cool. I'm going to go play some golf now, right? I mean, this is what he's saying. I mean, I'm not making this up. This is exactly what's happened. This is exactly what he's saying, and it all lines up word for word. He's telling you what his plan was, how they were going to institute it, and what he was managed to be successful on. He even goes so far to say, but he said, well, let me skip this, because that's not real relevant there. He's just trying to bring up and cause more racial issues that aren't really as bad as he wants to make them seem. He said, I can say, and I can demonstrate, and I can document that the country is a lot better off now than it was when I took office in almost every dimension. But what I can also say is that we could be doing even better. There are times when I reflect and ask myself, is there something else that I could have done? Something that I could have said slightly different that would have led to additional progress and less polarization. Now, what he's saying is this his help to push Agenda 21 and to get everybody under Sharia law, to eventually get into martial law, to get into these FEMA camps, to get the population, this plan put together by the United Nations psychos and the global elites like the George Soros, Bill Gates, etc., is actually coming to pass and doing quite well, but sometimes he wishes he could have done more but make it less polarizing. And what does he mean by less polarizing? Well, basically, he wishes there was a way that he could have done more to push this plan to breed out white people out of existence, put everybody in Sharia law, and to populate them without anybody really raising an eyebrow. That's what he's saying. He's like, man, I wish I could have done more of this without anybody knowing about it. But unfortunately, too many people were paying attention. Oh, well, at least I got a lot done. As I'll probably know, as I reflect on my presidency, once I'm out of just the day-to-day scrum of this thing, I'm sure I'll come up with a whole bunch of things to add to my list. But I think all of us have to do that. So, he says, in an interview with Rolling Stone last month, Obama said that as he hands the keys to the White House to Trump, he plans to sleep for a couple of weeks and take the First Lady, Michelle, on a well-deserved vacation. The one of the 10,000 that he's taken this year. Because I don't know when he seems to be actually working, because it seems like every dang day, this man's on vacation. Where do I sign up for that benefit plan? They said after that, he's going to spend his time in office writing a book, and he's going to be organizing his presidential center. We're just going to be focused on precisely on this issue of how do we train and empower the next generation of leadership? How do we rethink our storytelling, the messaging, and the use of technology and digital media so that we can make a persuasive case across the country? A persuasive case for what, you may ask? Well, exactly what he was just discussing. Talking about breeding the white out of the planet. Talking about putting everybody under Muslim rule and Sharia law, eventually logging them into the FEMA camp so they can depopulate 80 to 90% of the planets, which will not include the rich and the elites, because as we've seen from people like Hillary Clinton, who are not getting prosecuted, that they are, in fact, above the law and above reproach. And he's going to find more and future and better ways to help implement this plan and brainwash your future Americans into going along with this because, well, a lot of people are just uneducated, so let's just prey on them. So, that's it, y'all. I don't know what else I can say, but Obama just, we've been talking about all the things that Obama's been doing during his administration. He's come out and admitted what he's done in his administration, how he wishes he could have done more without people noticing, and what he plans to do in the future to make sure that this continues, and that no matter what happens, he's already changed this country so much with immigration that the bloodline in this country will never be the same, and it will never recover, just like in Sicily. You guys take care.